So welcome back to lecture number 9 in machine learning section, and this lecture is about Bayesian information criterion and agglomerative hierarchical clustering. This is basically an unsupervised clustering algorithm. So the aim of this lecture is to provide you an overview of the BIC and hierarchical clustering using the BIC score. We often use agglomerative hierarchical clustering using the distance score or the distance metric. But in this lecture, I will provide an overview of how to use BIC score in your hierarchical clustering algorithm. This lecture will be used as a prerequisite in the video presentation Machine Learning Active Project channel, where I will show the working of this method in 7 speakers speech signal. Now this was the original signal that I had to create for my project, and the length of the signal was about 7 minutes. Each speaker was allotted 1 minute to speak, and then I had to segment this signal using the BIC algorithm. Now this algorithm is a bit different from the BIC clustering algorithm, but the main idea is the same. And how? I will show you. So this was a original BIC curve that I got for 7 speaker data audio signal. This was a 7 minute of signal, and this was a BIC curve that I got for this signal. Now these were the peaks representing the transition points in a signal. Now these are the actual peaks that my algorithm determined, that these are the peaks. It means that these are the transition points. Okay, as you can see here, the text transition as well as speaker transition occurred, and here only the speaker transition occurred, but the text was the same. So in this algorithm, I had to remove these small peaks. Okay, these very small peaks from this BIC curve. It means I had to select some peak. I had to select the peaks, and on the basis of these peaks, I had to form clusters. So the ideal number of clusters is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. As you can see, 6 peaks and 7 clusters. But on running this algorithm, I got exactly 41 peaks with 42 clusters. This was because these small peaks, these peaks were resulting into a different cluster. So now my task was to merge these adjacent clusters. So I had to run this BIC based clustering algorithm, and after running this algorithm, I got 8 clusters with 7 peaks, and the ideal was 7 clusters and 6 peaks. As you can see, the result after applying the hierarchical clustering and the ideal results are not very different from each other, are not very far from each other. So this is the whole project that I will explain in the Machine Learning Active Project channel, and you can also download the MATLAB code from that video. So for the BIC, the problem statement is basically model selection. So consider a regression problem. In a regression problem, we can produce an exact fit of a polynomial function over the data set by increasing the number of parameters. But we know that as we increase the number of parameters, the overfitting also increases. So our task is to determine the appropriate number of parameters in a regression model. Again, we can do this by Kullback-Leibler divergence or Bayesian information criterion, but Bayesian information criterion is more robust than the Kullback-Leibler divergence. So basically the problem is hypothesis testing, which hypothesis to choose. So the overfitting can be avoided by Kullback-Leibler divergence or Bayesian information criterion, which is basically a hypothesis testing algorithm. There are other parametric and non-parametric algorithms. Non-parametric is cross-validation, and parametric methods is like BIC, because BIC assumes that your data is coming from a Gaussian distribution. Same is the problem with clustering. We will deal with the regression problem in the upcoming lecture. In the lecture which is focused only on the BIC, that will be lecture 11th or lecture 10th. Okay. So suppose you are having n. Suppose we are having a data set of n points, and suppose initially we had 20 clusters. We can start from n clusters, but to make you understand, let me consider 20 clusters. Now suppose we are continuously reducing the number of clusters from 20 to 19, 18, and then we reach 5 clusters. Say this is level 1. Now the problem is to identify the clusters that we can merge so that we can move on to level 2. Okay, so this is our problem. We had 5 clusters at level 1. Say these are represented as 5 clusters with cluster names C1, C2 to C5, and each cluster is having some data points R1, R2, R3, R4, R5, such that the summation of R1 to R5 is equal to N, capital N. And now at this level we will calculate the BIC score for these set of clusters. Okay, and now we move on to level 2. So we want to check that whether we can merge these two clusters or not. So let us say we merge these two clusters, and now we'll calculate the BIC score of these set of clusters at level 2. Say it is Y, and the clusters are represented as C1, 2, C3, C4, C5 with number of data points in each as R1 plus R2, R3, R4 and R5. So we'll calculate a BIC score, say Y. And now if Y is greater than X, then we can merge these two clusters. So this is a basic idea behind the BIC score for hierarchical clustering. And in exact mathematical terms, this is just consider a data set X which is having n capital N points. So suppose each Xi is an n dimensional feature vector, and we have and such instances. Consider set of models capital M with models from M1 to MK, with each model having say consider this is your regression problem, and your Xi's are your training instances, and your Mi's, that is M1 to MK, represent the different number of models, and each model is having different number of parameters. Say model M1 is having one parameter, and likewise model MK is having K parameters. So you want to identify that which is the best model for your regression problem. That is, you need to find the appropriate number of parameters for a regression problem. So we can calculate the likelihood of data set on each of the model, okay, and say there are, and say the PI, the number of parameters in each model MI. Okay, so there are PI parameters in each model MI. So as the training, so this is a BIC score. And as this, and as the number of parameter increases, your likelihood function increases, because your curve will exactly fit your data as you increase the number of parameters. But this penalty factor also increases. So this is basically your likelihood, your measure of your likelihood, and this is a penalty for more complex models. As you increase the number of parameters, the complexity increases, and therefore this term is penalizing the complexity of the model. Okay, so as the number of parameter in the model increases, likelihood increases, but penalty also increases. So the problem is to find the maximum BIC score. So we try to maximize the BIC.